everyone. Welcome to Master to Teach Step by Step Guide. In this video, you will learn what is functional point in software engineering, how to calculate functional point for project estimation, and we will see the examples of functional point calculation with its uses. I will try my best to explain step by step. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please click on the subscribe button and subscribe to our YouTube channel. It's really difficult to weigh the real values or worth of software. One of the best way to estimate the software development cost and time is based on the previous software development experience. To measure the standard worth of the software, as a unit of software worth, functional point was developed. Functional point was first defined by Allan of IBM in 1977. It is used effectively as a means for measuring the functionality delivered by a system. Functional point measures functionality from the user's point of view, like what the user receives from the software and what the user requests for the software. It focuses on what functionality is being delivered. According to the wiki, a functional point is a unit of measurement to express the amount of business functionality an information system provides to a user. Using historical data, the functional point matrix can then be used to estimate the cost or effort required to design, code, and test the software, predict the number of errors that will be encountered during testing, forecast the number of components and/or the number of projected source lines in the implemented system. Functional points are derived using an empirical relationship based on countable measures of software information domains and qualitative assessments of software complexity. The five functional units which is considered information domains as input to calculate the functional point are internal logic files, ILF, the control info or logically related data that is present within the system, external interface files, EIF, the control data or other logical data referred by the system but presents in another system, external input, data or control input that comes from outside our system, external output, data that goes out of the system after generation, external inquiries, combination of input and output resulting data retrieval. Now let's move to calculate functional point. To calculate functional point, the functional relationship is used. Functional point is equal to UFP into CAF, where UFP is unadjusted functional point and CAF is complexity adjustment factor. Let's follow step by step. Step 1. Calculating unadjusted functional point. Each functional point is ranked according to complexity. There exist predefined weights for the each functional point in each category. Organizations that use functional point methods develop criteria for determining whether a particular entry is simple, average, or complex. Nonetheless, the determination of complexity is somewhat subjective. Unadjusted functional point is called to sum of all the complexity of the EI, EOs, EQs, ILFs, and EIF, external inputs, external outputs, external inquiries, external interface files, and internal logic files. Step 2. Calculating CAF, complexity adjustment factor. Complexity adjustment factor, as we know, complexity adjustment factor is equal to 0.65 plus 0.01 into summation FI, where FI is value adjustment factor based on responses to the following 14 questions. Complexity adjustment factor is calculated using 14 aspects of processing complexity, and these 14 questions answer on the scale of 0 to 5. 0 means no influence or no importance, 1 mean incidental, 2 mean moderate, 3 mean average, 4 mean significant, 5 mean essential. To illustrate the use of functional point matrix, let's see a simple analysis model. Say form. The function manages user interaction, accepting a user password to activate or deactivate the system, and allows inquiries on the status of security zones and various security sensors. The function displays a series of prompting messages and sends appropriate control signals to various components of the security system. The data flow diagram is evaluated to determine a set of the key information domain measures required for computations of the function point matrix. 3 external inputs, password, panic button, and activate or deactivate. Two external inquiries, zone inquiry and sensor inquiry. One ILF, system configuration file. Two external input, messages and sensor status. And four EIF, test sensor, zone setting, activate, deactivate, and alarm alert. Now, calculating unadjusted functional point with the simple weighting factor. Therefore, UFP, unadjusted functional point, is equal to 50. Now, moving to calculate CAF. As we know, CAF is equal to 0.65 plus 0.01 into summation Fi. Let's calculate in a moderately complex product. Then, summation Fi is equal to 14 into 2 is equal to 28. Because all the 14 questions are answered in the moderate form, which is equal to 2. So that 14 into 2 is equal to 28. CAF is equal to 0.93. As we know, functional point is equal to UFP into CAF. Unadjusted functional point is equal to 50 and CAF is equal to 0.93. Therefore, functional point is equal to 46.5. Based on the projected functional point values derived from the requirement model, the project team can estimate the overall implemented size of the SafeHome user interaction function. Assume that past data indicates that one functional point translates into 60 lines of code and that 12 functional points are produced for each person month of effort. This historical data provides the project manager with important planning information that is based on the requirements model rather than preliminary estimates. Assume further that past projects have found an average of 3 errors per function point during requirements and design review, and 4 errors per functional point during the unit and integration testing. This data can ultimately help you to assess the completeness of your review and testing activities. Let's see one more example of calculating functional point. Given the functional values, calculate the functional point when complexity adjustment factor are significantly complex product and weighting factor are high. User input is equal to 55. User output is equal to 35, user inquiry is 40, user files 8, whereas external interfaces 5. We know that functional point is equal to unadjusted functional point multiplication of CAF, complexity adjustment factor, where UFP is equal to sum of all the complexities of the 5 input variables, and CAF is equal to 0.65 plus 0.0 into summation Fi, and where summation Fi is equal to value adjustment factor. Now let's calculate unadjusted functional point. Filling table data, here we are required to calculate in the high weighting factor so that unadjusted functional point is equal to 330 plus 245 plus 240 plus 120 plus 50, which is equal to 985. Now moving to calculate CAF, complexity adjustment factor. CAF is equal to 0.65 plus 0.01 into summation Fi. Here, we are required to calculate all 14 complexity factors in significantly complex. Hence, summation Fi is equal to 14 into 4 is equal to 56. Therefore, CAF is equal to 1.21. What if complexity factor of 5 questions are average, 5 questions are moderate, and 4 questions are no influence? Then, summation Fi is equal to 5 into 3 plus 5 into 2 plus 4 into 0 is equal to 25. Therefore, final functional point is equal to UFP into CAF. Unadjusted functional point multiplication of CAF is complexity adjustment factor. Therefore, functional point is equal to 985 into 1.21, which is equal to 1191.85. In this way, we can calculate the unadjusted functional point, complexity factor, and finally functional point, from which we can estimate the lines of codes required to develop the software, the number of probability errors, the effort required, development time, etc. concerning previous data. I hope you learned from this video tutorial. If you have any questions or comments, please make sure to leave a comment in the comment section below. Also, please be sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Thank you very much for watching. Check us out for more in IT tutorial and guide on website mastertoteach.com. And we will see you again soon. Bye.